classification of anti-hypertensive agents. So mainly the first class includes the diuretics, thiazide diuretics. Examples are hydrochlorothiazide, then loop diuretics, furosemide, then potassium sparing diuretics, triamterin. Then the second class are the sympatholytic drugs. In sympatholytic drugs, further we have different classes of drugs. The first class include in sympatholytic agents, that is centrally acting drugs. The examples for these are the methyl dopa. Then this is the structure of methyl dopa. So before we discuss that, I just want to tell you what is meant by catechol amine or catechol nucleus. So catechol nucleus is nothing but the benzene with the benzene containing the hydroxyl group ortho to each other. Then we call that type of nucleus as catechol. Okay, so this is called as catechol, right? So this is catechol. And in most of the cases, that is initially discovered drugs. See, even if you look into the structure of norepinephrine also, it has got the catechol nucleus. So that's why these adrenaline, noradrenaline related compounds are known as catechol amines. So while amine, why they are called as catechol amines? Because the side chain of the substituted catechol nucleus has got the amine group. That's why this is called as the, these compounds are called as, or norepinephrine and epinephrine are called as the catechol amines. The catechol nucleus, this is the catechol nucleus. So coming to the drugs which are acting at the central level, that is in the CNS, that is methyl dopa and then clonidine. So the, in case of methyl dopa, the catechol nucleus is present, whereas in case of clonidine, we don't see any catechol nucleus. Then coming to the other drugs which are present in this centrally acting drugs include guanabens. So slightly it has got similarity with the clonidine, but instead of the benzimidazole nucleus, you have the guanidine part. So this particular part is known as the guanidine. Okay, so urea substituted with the NH2. Actually, urea is NH2, CONH2, but instead of oxygen, we are substituting it with the NH, then that is called as the guanidine nucleus. So clonidine, if you replace the imidazole nucleus of clonidine with the guanidine, then the compound becomes guanabens. So this is how you have to remember. So you can keep on by hearting all the structures. So you will have to learn them relatively. What is the difference? Then coming to the other compound, that is guanfacin. So this is also similar to that of guanabens. But the thing is, here you have a carbonyl group between the dichlorobenzene and the guanidine nucleus or guanidine part. So this is how we can easily remember the structure of clonidine, guanabens and guanfacin. Right. Then coming to the ganglionic blockers, we have two compounds in this class, that is the, that is mecamelamine, the is one drug, and then the other drug that we have in this class is trimethaphan. So this is the, these are two drugs which act at the ganglia of the adrenergic system. Then coming to the third category of sympatholytic agents, we have the adrenergic neuron blocking system, neuron blocking agents. So these adrenergic neuron blocking agents, we have a further classification like formation of false neurotransmitters. Example, it is methyl dopa. Then depletion of storage sites that is, you see, while we have discussed about the biosynthesis of norepinephrine, we have told that the storage vesicles have the norepinephrine stored in them, and when there is a signal transduction, then the release of the membrane of these vesicles is destabilized, and the release of the norepinephrine takes place.
Sir, కొంతమందికి అలౌ చేయాలంట సార్
ఎవరమ్మా
కొంతమందికి అలౌ చేయాలంట సార్ కొంతమంది కనెక్ట్ అవ్వట్లేదంట సార్
44 మెంబర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ 1 మినిట్ దెన్ ది అదర్ క్లాస్ ఆఫ్ డ్రగ్స్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ స్టోరేజ్ సైట్స్ దట్ ఇస్ ది రెజర్పిన్ ఇస్ ది కాంపౌండ్ విచ్ డిప్లీట్స్ ది stored norepinephrine from the storage vesicles. Then the inhibition of release and enhance uptake mechanism, that is guanethidine is the compound. So we have seen the reuptake mechanism in the biosynthesis. So they will enhance the reuptake mechanism and inhibit release of, that is alpha 2 receptor, isn't it? So they will inhibit the release norepinephrine. Then stimulation of presynaptic and alpha 2 receptor, that is clonidine and alpha methyl dopa, are the two examples which act as presynaptic alpha 2 receptors. Okay, then the other class in the sympatholytic agents, that is beta adrenergic blocking agents. So examples in this class are the beta non-selective compounds, which include propranolol, then pindolol, timolol, and nadolol. Apart from that, there are many compounds. So let us see the relationship between these drugs. Okay. So propranolol. So this is the naphthalene nucleus. Okay. And so here to this you have the substitution. If you look into the substitution, OCH2CHOH CH2NH CH CS3 CS3, so this is the substitution present on the naphthalene nucleus. Okay, so this compound is called as the propranolol. So this is called as propranolol. Okay, and then if you look into the pindolol, so there is only change in the instead of naphthal, the benzene ring is fused with the one of the heterocyclic nucleus. Okay, so this is the change that you can note from the propranolol and pindolol. And if you look into the side chain is similar to the propranolol, OCH2CHOH CH2NH CS3. Okay, then coming to the next part, that is the timolol. So in timolol, you don't have the fused ring systems. Here you have a heterocyclic cyclic ring, and you have the that is the morpholine linked to this, and then side chain is same, OCH2CHOH CH2NH CH CS3. You have the same side chain. And if you look into the nadolol, the nadolol is similar to that of propranolol, except that the one of the benzene ring is saturated, so the side chain remains the same. This is how you can easily remember the structures of propranolol, pindolol, timolol, and nadolol. So these are all the drugs which act on both. They do not have selectivity towards beta 1, beta 2 receptors. Okay, they act both on the beta 1 and beta 2 receptors. Then coming to the selective beta 1 blockers, so in this you have acebutolol. So acebutolol, the side chain of acebutolol is same as that of the propranolol, and instead of naphthalene ring you have the benzene, and COCH3 ortho substitution and para substitution you have NHCO CH2 CH2 CS3. Okay, that is a propyl compound, and this is an amide linkage. Okay, acebutolol. And atenolol, you have the here in atenolol also same side chain as that of acetabitolol, but here thing is that you have CH2CO NH2. This is the para position substitution on the benzene nucleus. So this is atenolol. Then coming to the esmolol, this is also a beta 1 selective compound. The side chain is same, but the para position you have CH2CH3COOCH3. Okay, so the ester functional group you have in case of esmolol, whereas in case of the atenolol you have the CH2CO NH2, whereas in acetabitolol you have the amide linkage NHCO CH2CH2CH3. Okay, these are the three compounds. Only a few examples only we have seen here. And then coming to the next part, alpha adrenergic blocking drugs. This is mainly alpha one blockers. So here you have prazosin as the example, alpha one blocker example. Then apart from that, you have the phentolamine. This is the structure of phentolamine. They act on the alpha one receptor. Then coming to the next part, that is mixed drugs, that is which act both on alpha and as well as the beta adrenergic receptors and act as blockers. So the first example is carvedilol. This is the structure of carvedilol. Okay, and the side chain we have slightly similar to the propanol, OCH2CHOH CH2NH, but from here you have the change in it. So this is different from the side chain of the compound. Okay, then coming to the next compound, that is labetalol. So this is the structure of labetalol. And then see, in case of the before compound, the alpha one blockers, apart from prazosin and phentolamine, we have terazosin and doxazosin also. See, terazosin and doxazosin are similar in all aspects except for the substitution at this particular point. Okay, so you have a saturated furan nucleus here, and whereas the fused ring system, benzene with the heterocyclic ring system, is there in the doxazosin. And then the next part, that is the mixed alpha, we have seen carvedilol and labetalol. Then coming to the vasodilators, we have arterial vasodilators. The examples are hydralazine and then minoxidil. Apart from that, diazoxide is one of the compound which is acting as arterial vasodilators. Then coming to the arterial and the venous vasodilators, you have sodium nitro prusside as the compound. Then apart from that, we have calcium channel blockers. As we know that there are very many calcium channel blockers which can be used, that is verapamil, diltiazem, nifedipine, mainly the depin class of compounds. That is all various types of nifedipines can be used as the antihypertensive drugs. Then apart from that, ACE inhibitors, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, we have seen captopril, enalapril. Okay, and then angiotensin receptor blockers, we have seen losartan as the example. So these are all the compounds are the drugs which are commonly used as the antagonists and after some receptors. They have activity at beta and alpha receptors. Okay, so this is the classification. Then coming to the classification of, see, these beta adrenergic blockers are one of the class of drugs which are used as antihypertensives, and they play an important role in treatment of hypertension. So let us see further classification of these beta blockers. So these beta blockers can be further classified into, that is based on their there is generations from which period to which period, or in, during which period they have been released into the market. So these beta adrenergic blockers, okay, so beta adrenergic blockers can be further classified into beta adrenergic blockers can be further classified into based on their generations, okay, generations classified. So the first class of drugs are the first generation of beta blockers. So beta blockers, you have the examples here, you have the examples. So this is the structure of the compound. We have already written in the classification. So if they ask you exclusively about the beta blockers, then you have to write this classification. CH2, then NH, CH, CH3. CH3. So this is the structure of propranolol. Propranolol. Right. Then the other drugs which we have already noted in the classification are timolol, and then pindolol. These are the compounds which were released earlier in the treatment of the hypertension. Then coming to the second generation of beta blockers. Okay, so second generation of beta blockers, which include examples. Okay. This proctolol, that is the first example that we can write here, is the proctolol. So at the para position you have NHCOCH3, and then the benzene ring which we have got CH2, CHOH, and then the NH, the other thing remains the same, CH3 and CH3. So this is the proctolol. So this is the name of the drug, that is structure, proctolol. Then the other examples which we have already seen are acetylbutolol, and then other compound is atenolol, which we have already discussed in the classification. Then the other compound is, that is the compound is the metoprolol, CH2CH2OCH3. The name of the compound is metoprolol. Prolol. So the side chain of it is CH3. So this is metoprolol. This is all these three drugs, that is the proctolol, sibutolol, atenolol, and metoprolol, belong to the second generation of beta blockers. And coming to the next generation, that is the third data blockers. So the examples of these drugs are the ethanol all. Examples are that is the CN and you have the side chain NH, CH2, NH, and then C double bond O, CH2, then a benzene ring. So this is the structure of the compound. This is the ethanol all. Then apart from that, we have thimidol all. The compound structure of this compound. So here you have the ortho position methyl substitution. That is the side chain structure is similar to the ethanol all. And you have the pyrimidine nucleus partially saturated structure in this. This is the structure of the pyrimidol all. Okay. Then coming to the other compound in third generation, we have that is the C double bond O, and you have this so you have is another compound. The name of the compound is xamotirol. So these are the compounds which belong to the third class of our third generation. Then coming to the other so these are the few examples. Then coming to the propranolol, which is a non-selective beta blocker. So propranolol is the one which is obtained from the there is the alpha naphthol. From alpha naphthol it is being prepared. Okay, then we have the mode of action of all these drugs. That is, they will be acting on different receptors, and they have the activity. So